Hi there. My name is Timothytrespas, and I'm a human being who has found himself targeted, inoculated with Morgellons, gang stop, drug, microwave, mind control, torture, torment, forced relocation, sickness, on and on and on. I just wanted to mention that today, as I was going out, I wanted to shave, so I shaved. I have an electric razor, and the strangest thing, as soon as I began to shave, I started pouring sweat, like, you know, like I'd just been in the desert, running in the sun, like pouring, dripping, you know, like a cupful, you know, and I'm shaving, and all these little hairs in my face are going, because they're alive, there's stuff in them, and they're freaking out, and then all the little bumps are bumping out even further, and, you know, I just touch it, and blood pours out, and oh my God. So I'm shaving and I'm pouring sweat and I'm bleeding, and you know, there's these hairs that just do not come out. You shave and shave, you pull at them with the tweezers and they pull back. And you know, I'm looking at myself at the wrinkles and the you know, this stuff is all in the last few years, and it's not from aging, it's from whatever this disease and these parasites and this micro, you know, this thing that they claim is delusional is killing me. And, you know, it's such a strange reaction to shave and be dripping. So I go and I wash my hands and I wash my face, and there's black stuff coming off of me, like, you know, I had just washed my hands a half an hour earlier. I had just done the dishes, and it's like every time I wash, there's more black stuff coming off of me. And I don't think that it's all just dirt, because, you know, you keep washing and cleaning and wiping, and oh, now the headache. All right, the sharp, pulsing pain in my head, problems with my vision, and dehydrated, drinking, trying to replenish the liquid. And to me, the water looks different. To me, the water pours differently. It feels different. It tastes different. It doesn't seem to hydrate the same way. And you know, I'm a fool. I know very little about my health or my body and nutrition, and I've been blessed, you know, with this wonderful health for a while, even though I was given 16 inoculations as a child, vaccinations, and was so sick with earaches that made me scream for days, and headaches and fevers and canker sores in my mouth. I just remember screaming and crying in pain for days and days, and the doctors, you know, nobody seemed to know. I had white bumps all over the backs of my arms, which I still have today. Now I have them in my nose, in my mouth, inside of my lips, under my tongue, in my ears. You know, now I have cysts, little tiny cysts everywhere, and these blackheads that aren't blackheads, they make cysts, and you touch them and this pain shoots down from this tiny place. It hurts so much, and I become hypersensitive to hot and cold. When I'm out in the cold, it hurts so much. know, there were times where I fell down in pain on the ground, you know, writhing in pain because I was so cold and it hurt so much. There's been times where I wake up and it feels like there's things in my lips, you know, moving around in my nose and my lips, and you can't get rid of it. And these hairs that grow, these long, long hairs that grow out of the backs of my arms and my neck and elsewhere on my body, and they each come with a little dot, a little cyst, it's like a histamine reaction or something, because all of a sudden, you know, you touch one or you shave or you something and they all go, and all the pimple things, the black, they all pop out and are irritated and hurting and bleeding, and, you know, it's insane. It's impossible. And, you know, I walk around on the street and people are like, oh my god, look at you, you must be smoking crack, look at, he's got AIDS. I've been dealing with this for years, man. You know, and I thought it was all my fault. I thought I was, you know, something was wrong with me, that I was to blame, that I wasn't whatever enough, that I was doing it to myself somehow, nervously. No, this is something that was done to me, and I'm trying to survive it without constantly focusing on the negative aspects and the fear that's pumped through me, and the, you know, preparing for death, you know. The moment these people started with the gang stalking and the "we're gonna kill you, you're gonna die" over and over and over, and I was on so much hallucinogenic, God knows what, put it in our food, they blew it on us, they walked up to us and sprayed us with little canisters and encircled us on the street, 10, 12 people, and throw things at us. Nobody seems to notice here in New York, you know? It's like, I would walk down Midtown Manhattan, you know, 100 million people in 5 blocks, and nobody say a fucking word. People throwing things at me, and I got shit on my face, and my clothes are ruined, and I'm like, you know, just trying to put up with it and not flip out. And God, this disease, this thing, this whatever it is affecting my brain and my body, and I'm losing my ability to have any patience. I get frustrated so easy, I get angry so easy, and when I get frustrated or angry, my brain shuts down. I lose my appetite, I can't think, I cannot concentrate, I can't even put a sentence together. I you know, I can't decide what to do. I don't know what the next, you know, whether I should sit down or walk around or eat, not eat, or walk. And I have to wait until this stops, and then I have to take this medication for the anxiety and the hopes that I won't take too much and knock myself out, and I'll be asleep for the rest of the day, and not too much, you know, and not enough. I take the pill, I break it, I bite off a little crumb, and that's enough, you know. It's really torturous, and, you know, I live in a world where every day we're told, oh, you have to look so pretty, and you wear your makeup, and wear your nice clothes, and have a good fit into the social, you know. And I'm Frankenstein, you know? I'm Skeletor. Except I'm not evil. Well, Frankenstein wasn't evil. He was a good guy, just misunderstood. And, I don't know what I'm trying to say. I'm just trying to get this out. And you know, wait for the medicine to kick in. And I gotta go to the bank now. And everywhere I go, I'm treated like like I'm doing something wrong, you know, like to get my money out of the bank, or to get my prescriptions filled, or it's crazy, you know, it's like, so I try to smile and be friendly and it's nice and, you know, do the best I can, and so it goes, and I thank God for another day. Another breath, another heartbeat, another thought, and for the blessings that I do have, and the people who do care, and, you know, for everybody else who's going through this, I'm there with you, you know, I know, I understand, and I care, I just wish I could make it better. So I have to accept it. I have to accept the powerlessness. I have to accept the confusion and the sickness. And the... Anyway, thanks for watching. God bless you all.